finally it snowed. We've been waiting for ages for the snow, and it's finally started coming down properly now, which is lovely. You see behind me here, kind of what it looks like now. It's a lovely time of the year to come out. What I wanted to do while I'm out here really is just briefly go over the kind of clothing you should be thinking of wearing, certainly in this environment, if you're planning on going into the forest and bushcrafting and that kind of thing. Now, it's not overly cold today, it's -9 I believe, or thereabouts. Snow's not too heavy. We've got about 6 inches up here on top of the hill. But you do need to consider the cold. Now for me, I've got a fur hat on. This one's actually moose leather and wolf fur. It's a natural fight. It's natural fur. There's no point really buying synthetic. It doesn't shed ice, snow, and rain particularly well. It's certainly not as well as real fur does. I know there's a big argument about it, but the fact is it does the job it is designed for by nature. So who am I to argue with that? Now, jacket wise, I've got my Ridgeline Monsoon. This is the first edition. I think they've made 3 now, which have like the cuffs and all the rest of it. But this is a fantastic jacket. It's nice and long in the body. It's a smock, so you pull it over your head. It's got a sort of 3/4 length zip at the top. Nice big matte pocket with a waterproof cover on the front. And then a big puff style chest pocket, which just holds tons of stuff. It's got a cinched waist. And then really that's it. Now this one, the first design came with a non-detachable hood that rolled up and went into the collar. I didn't get on with it personally. I found the collar stood up too rigidly, and I couldn't wear it. It felt like, like Elvis. And then when you had it out, it was only attached by a very small point on the back. So in the wind and things, it tends to flap around. So I cut that off, and I fitted it with poppers, so I can just attach it as and when I need it. Works for me. Now, under that, I'm wearing the Ridgeline Storm Jacket, they call it. Very similar to the Buffalo mountain shirts. But to be honest, this is an oomph of the price. I know people that have had Buffalo shirts. This is no different, except that it's a damn sight cheaper. So yeah, under that, I've then just got an Under Armour t-shirt. And I'm toasty warm. These are brilliant. And for bushcraft, these coats are fantastic. I've sat by fires. You can go through thorns and thick brush, and it just bounces off. Indestructible coats, they really are. On my hands, I've just got a pair of Swix Norwegian winter gloves. I normally wear mittens when I'm in the woods and things, but because I'm on the bike today, I needed to obviously have fingers and thumbs. On my legs, I've just got a pair of cheap sort of hunting trousers, really. I picked up in a market, but they're beautiful trousers. They're made of that kind of suede effecty kind of brushed cotton. I don't know what they call it. But they're lined for the winter, so they're really comfortable. And they come up, they've got like a high ridge bit around the base of the spine, which is nice because it keeps the back warm. Over that, I've got my belt, which has got my knife, my fire steel, and my torch on it. And then my Granninge boots, my leather boots, which I've shown in another video, my Swedish winter video, I think I showed the boots. If you're interested, have a look at that. And that's it really, guys. That is what I'm wearing. Like I say, it's not that cold, -8, -9, something like that. It's not too bad. But the forest is absolutely stunning. I'll spin you around and show you about. Yeah, so, like I say, come up on a bike, which is, so you're getting covered in snow. And this is basically just a mountain road that runs over the top through the forest. That's that one. truly gorgeous. I love this time of year. I was hoping to see some moose or something today. I think I'll probably try and head up the track a bit. I haven't got snow tyres or anything on my ATV. They're just your standard kind of all-rounders. They're not that great on the snow and the ice. But I'm going to head up, see how far I can get safely, and yeah, let's go for the ride.